Hello, in today's episode of Yinka and Friends, I'm at Shoreditch Dance Studios. I'm going to be talking to Kiesza all about her interesting journey into music, and she's going to be attempting to teach me some dance moves. So thank you for joining me.
Thanks, it's great to be here.
So whenever I'm going to interview someone, I get like a PR package of all their information and all that sort of stuff. And when I read yours, it's unbelievable the amount of things that you've done for someone so young. You were in the Navy, weren't you?
Yes, I was. I joined the Navy while I was still in high school, actually, around the age of 16. And I spent a whole summer training at boot camp. And when I was there, I won the Top Shot Award. So they were sort of looking at me more as a shooter and then sort of decided that wasn't the career path I wanted to go down.
Yeah.
Couldn't imagine myself actually ever shooting anyone or even just being in a war scenario. So I was a sailor prior to that, which is I think what sort of led me into the Navy as well. And then I just sort of, after the Navy, I really started to focus on music more. And
so was that your first sort of introduction to wanting to sing to people?
Yeah, I think that was when I discovered that my music connected with people.
So it had like a powery type.
Yeah, like prior to that, I had music was part of my life. Like I'd done classical piano. Mm-hmm. I was in musical theater as a kid. I was in the play Annie. You know, I was.
What character did you play?
You know, they wanted me for Annie, but at the time when I auditioned, I was the smallest person to audition, so I had to end up playing Molly.
Oh.
It seemed like the most obvious role for Annie. But I knew all of this. Yeah, I was really small. Music was always a part of my life, maybe in the background more. And then when I started actually playing for people, then I realized I had a way of connecting. And I was a folk musician when I started out, completely different. And I went on this whole musical journey where I explored every different genre you can think of. I mean, I was in a rock band. I was in a jazz band. I was a folk singer. What else? I even sang death metal once.
No way.
Yeah, this group, their singer couldn't make it to a gig, so I just jumped in and I was like wailing in death metal.
Do you feel like you found a home with the sort of music that you play?
Yes.
Or you create now?
It wasn't until I created Hideaway that I really connected with the music from like as my own music.
Yeah.
And that's not to say like my folk music I connect with. I'm telling stories, I'm telling of my own experience, but I never felt like that's who I am as an overall performer or as an artist, because it's missing elements. I love to dance. I brought the street dance into my music because I've always loved house. I've always loved the whole like underground scene and diva singers. And so I always loved that style of dancing. And I was more in admiration of people who did it.
But I think that when something's meant to be, it just falls together. So
with Hideaway, I totally agree with you there. Like I kind of felt while I was writing the song like that it kind of pre-existed and was just sort of forcing its way,
because you become almost like a channel for the music,
because it came out in one piece practically. So it was like I felt like I was sort of taking it from somewhere else, like I didn't even write it, but
but you know, it's awesome.
Thank you.
So did you expect the reaction from Hideaway? You must have had a niggle in, you know, knowing that everything happened
well. I don't know, like I was just having fun in the moment. I made this song that I loved, and then I wanted to make a video for it, so I, you know, rounded up all my friends, and everybody in the video was excited about trying to pull this stunt off of doing a one take. We weren't really looking into the future and thinking, I want this to be like a huge hit or anything. We just were doing something that we all loved. Like, everybody there wanted to be there. And after we saw the video, we were just like, wow, this is really cool. It turned out better than we thought. And then it was more when people started watching the video and reacting to it that I thought maybe this could actually be something bigger than all of us had originally thought. It just went from a completely independent fun project into like a really serious sort of career.
Well, I'm looking forward to following your journey in
Thank
music.
You.
And I don't know if you noticed, but we're at a dance studio. I'm not entirely sure if that was clear.
I was excited when I showed up.
And hopefully you can teach me some moves.
Yeah, definitely.
I've got to warn you, I'm not the best dancer at all, but I'm definitely up for it. And so are you ready?
Let's do it.
Yes.
So then you're gonna go the other direction as me. Your arm's gonna come and you're gonna like push yourself out, but you're gonna go this way.
Okay.
So while I go that way.
Okay.
So we're gonna go 1, 2, 3. Push, and then the other side. Push. How's that so far?
I feel like it's 300.
Okay, so I'm gonna teach you one move. Okay. Too legit to quit.
Too legit to quit.
Your legs are kind of straddled like this.
Yeah.
Your arms are gonna come around like this. Yeah.
Yeah.
And you're gonna clap. And when you after you clap, you're gonna go bam. Like, so it's like too legit to quit. Woo!
Okay.
Got it?
Too legit to quit.
Each other.
Okay.
So two. Woo!
Yeah.
That's your handshake.
Yeah. That's it. Secret handshake. You can never do that move again.